on you, that you feel that energy coming out of you, that poison being released, and you taste the salt as it comes down into your mouth. And just feel that complete release that only tears can bring. And I know each of the speakers before me spoke about how harmful it is to keep that inside. And, you know, we all try to keep it inside, but, I mean, sometimes things don't work that way. And it's okay. I don't care what people think about me. If I cry for something stupid. I lost my husband 2.5 years ago after a very long illness. But in spite of that, his death was a surprise. I mean, he had had diabetes for 20 years. His health was declining. He'd had 2 heart attacks and 5 back surgeries, and I was with him through all of that. And then his kidneys failed, and it was like we grieved the loss together of each function as he lost them. But we still celebrated life, and we still had the adventures that we were supposed to have, and we still laughed over so many things. But there was that long grieving process. And ultimately, when he had an adverse drug reaction that caused a condition called Stevens-Johnson syndrome, and the epidermis from the knees down blistered in giant golf ball-sized blisters, and the entire epidermis came off of him, that knowing he was a diabetic and knowing he was had kidney failure, the healing process was not going to work. And it was only in that, at that time, that I even thought for a moment that I could lose him. I mean, through everything else, I mean, kidney dialysis, we're doing kidney dialysis at home together, and it's all good. You know, it never dawned on me that he would actually pass. And even up until 10 days before he passed, now he had been battling this condition for almost 3 months at that time. And it just wasn't getting better, and I kept asking, should we be doing this? Should we be doing no, no, you can stay the course with this. And I'm like, 5 times to the hospital, it was not good. And 10 days before he passed, I'm in the intensive care unit with him and his sister. And they're getting ready to move him into a regular bed because they had stabilized him, they told me. And all of a sudden, his eyes rolled back in his head, and he's talking. And he's talking through the whole thing, and he's going, I can't hear you. There's a light. I'm walking to the light. There's nobody here. They're not ready for me. I'm coming back. And then he opened his eyes, and I was like, holy shit! Which was, I mean, literally. He came back because he still had unfinished things to do. 10 days later, he did pass. But before he did so, he gave me an incredible gift. He told me, you are going to do great things. And that gift has inspired me to keep going. When he did pass, he did so. Both of us without fear, both of us had peace, both of us without worry. Since that time, my healing journey has been amazing, and largely because of Awakening Giants. That was a major moment when I said yes to doing that, because it was that emotional, spiritual, physical journey that I needed to take care of me. And since that time, my life is an amazing adventure. I feel like I'm putting two workshops together at the same time, you know. I'm here now, and I know my husband's here with me. I went to Africa in September, and absolutely was there with me. On one amazing day on this African trip, we were in Chobe, which is the home to 100,000 immigrants. And the day had been absolutely amazing. We had watched lions mating in the morning. We had seen five lionesses feasting on a dead animal. And then in the afternoon, we were blessed to see the birth of a baby elephant. Now, our guide had been there in that part guiding for 29 years, had never seen a baby elephant be born. And spontaneously, the six of us in the van with the guide named the elephant Stanley. Because Stanley Livingston was a big deal down in that part of Africa. Mm-hmm. And our guide was Stanley. And afterwards I'm like, my husband was Stanley. He was there with me. And he's here with me now. And I'm so blessed. So emotional grief is something that is ongoing. I mean, stupid things, it's called SOOB, sudden outburst of grief. You could be absolutely fine, you're walking down the grocery aisle and you look at the sardines and say, oh my God, my husband loves sardines, ah! You know, and you start crying because it's like stupid sardines. I mean, I never ate a sardine, but he loved them. Those are the things that we carry with us, and those emotions are so powerful and so special. And we should embrace that grief and grow from it, because without being able to feel that emotion tells you you are alive and your life is worth everything that you are experiencing. So thank you so much for allowing me to speak.